editing. You gotta do it if you wanna make that dope video that's in your head, but sometimes it is so much easier just to keep filming, isn't it? Like just to keep capturing shot after shot until you've got this horde of video files on your computer that you know you should do something with, but oh, it just takes so long to edit, doesn't it? Well, in the next few lessons, we gonna work on that. Not only are you gonna learn to edit in a program that is as powerful as they come, but you're also gonna learn how to do it fast, because I know you got a life to live. So in the next four lessons, we're gonna be walking step by step through the editing process, and of course, we're gonna be using our picnic sequence footage, which you're welcome to use as well if you want. You can download that below, or if you just wanna skip that altogether and jump straight into using your cinematic sequence footage, you can also use that and work your way through these editing lessons as well. If you are using our picnic footage, you can copy our sequence exactly, or you can remix it if you want, but you cannot submit as your cinematic sequence our picnic footage. You've got to do something that you conceptualize and shoot yourself for your project. All right, for our video editor, we are gonna be using Premiere Pro. Now, she's not perfect and there are other options, but we prefer Premiere Pro because number one, it's got crazy capabilities. So if you wanna edit a feature film on it, she's got you. Number two, it's totally customizable. So if you're a member of the Control Freak Club like I am, you're gonna feel right at home. Number three, it's an industry standard, so it's gonna make collaborating with other people really easy. And number four, it works well with other Adobe apps like Illustrator, After Effects, Photoshop, and so if you use those other apps a lot, that is a big bonus. Now, if you don't already have Premiere Pro, I've got a link down below where you can go to buy it. Obviously, if you get an annual plan, they're gonna give you a better deal, but there are also monthly plans if you're not ready to commit and take the plunge, and there's also a 7-day trial if you wanna cop that first. So if you don't have Premiere, go get it now, and don't watch the rest of this video until you do, because that would just be dumb. Don't do that. All right, so let's get into what you're learning. In this first lesson, you're gonna be creating your project in Premiere. You're going to explore Premiere's workspace and learn where everything is. And then of course, you're gonna be importing and organizing your assets so you can get to cutting in the next lesson. All right, let's jump into this edit. All right, so we're gonna create a project in Premiere. And the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make a folder. I always like to add the date and the project name, but you can name that folder whatever you want. And I see you over there making your folder. You are killing it already. Go you. Now, where are you gonna put this folder? Well, for this practice project and for other small projects, you're probably fine just saving them on your computer. But if you're gonna be doing multiple projects and you don't wanna delete your video files for a while, or you're shooting everything in 8K, then you're probably better off saving everything to an external hard drive with a really fast speed, especially because video files ain't small and Premiere Pro can be a little bit demanding and you don't want to overstress your computer. All right, so let's get back to our folder here. Every new project that you create in Premiere gets its own folder. I cannot stress how important this is. This is the folder where you want to put all the precious assets that are for your project. You do not want to save them some random place like on your desktop, because if you do, your files are gonna get so stressed out on your desktop thinking that you might forget that they belong to a project and accidentally delete them. And then you're gonna open up Premiere and Premiere is gonna be like, yo, where are those files at? And then it's gonna give you the dreaded media offline screen, which if you've never seen it, count your blessings. This is a screen that sends fear through the souls of every editor. But the point is, make sure that you keep all of your project assets in this project folder. With that said, we're now gonna add some assets to this project folder, and I've got some files from our picnic sequence here. So we've got videos, songs, images, and again, these can be downloaded in the link in the lesson below. If you are using your own files from your own cinematic sequence that you shot, I would recommend giving those files a unique file name. The reason you wanna do this is because there have been a couple nightmare situations that I've had with Premiere, and I'm not saying this is gonna happen to you, but we're gonna doomsday prep here, people. So there have been a couple situations where I have left my video files with this generic file name, which I used to do all the time. And you know, Premiere accesses your files by their file path. But a couple times Premiere has lost that file path. And so it gives me this little pop-up message, an error saying, yo, I forgot where that file with the generic name C0001.mp4 is. Can you tell me where it is again? And I'm like, say what? I got like a million of those files named C0001.mp4. How am I supposed to know which one it is? And we are talking hours trying to sort out that mess. And I don't want that to happen to you. You know, it only takes a couple seconds to rename your files. So I'm just gonna select all here, right click, and then click rename. I usually add the date and then the device name, whether it's a camera or an audio recorder. And I just put that before the file name, click rename, and boom, everything's got a unique name and we are prepared for disaster. Okay, so now let's finally create our project in Premiere Pro. So we're gonna go to Premiere Pro down here and launch that. And then you might see this welcome screen. And I've got some recent projects down here because you know your girl's been busy. But you're gonna go up here to this new project button, or you can also go to File, New Project. And then it's gonna ask us to name our project. So I'm gonna name this Picnic Cinematic Sequence. And now it's asking us for a location. So where are we gonna set it? We're gonna set it to that folder that we made specifically for this project. All right, the rest of these settings, we can leave them as they are. And then we're gonna go over to the second tab called Scratch Disks. And all of these things want a location. These are folders that are gonna be related to your project. And I like to set that to that same project folder again, so I got everything in one place. There we go, now we're gonna press okay. And we are in, so welcome. First question is, are you using headphones to edit your video? Maybe you're sharing the room with somebody that you don't want to drive crazy while you're editing.
Don't want to drive crazy while you're editing. Don't want to drive crazy while you're editing. Don't want to drive crazy while you're editing.
If that is the case, then you want to go up to your Premiere Pro menu and you want to go to Preferences. Then you want to go to Audio Hardware and you want to make sure that the default output is set to built-in output. And then down here, headphones should pop up. If headphones doesn't pop up down below, then you need to go to your built-in output on your computer and make sure that headphones is selected here. All right, so when you first open up Premiere, you're going to see a screen that looks like this. And this whole situation here is called a workspace. And if we click around this workspace, you're gonna see that we've got different boxes that are being highlighted in blue. And each one of these boxes is called a panel. And each panel does something different. So this panel down here, we've got tools in it, right? Or this panel, we've got more metadata than we would ever know what to do with unless we were making some Hollywood film, right? But if we're working on a project, then we really only want the panels up that we need at the time that we need them, right? Like you wouldn't have everything out in your kitchen all at once. You might have these things out when you're prepping ingredients, or these things out when you're cooking, or these things out when you're plating, right? Because of this, we've got different workspace presets up here, and each one of these workspace presets is gonna give us different panels for different phases of our video edit. And so the color workspace is gonna give us some cool color tools, and the audio workspace is going to give us some cool audio stuff going on over here. But back in our project, we're going to use the assembly workspace, so make sure you got that clicked. And then let's talk a little bit more about these panels. So you'll notice that some of the panels, like this timeline panel, is all by itself, and then some of the panels are stacked on top of each other in tabs, and you can take any one of these panels and move them anywhere on the screen you want, and then you can also resize them. And then let's say there's a panel that you don't think you need, like you don't need all this metadata, you can go up to this hamburger menu and you can select Close Panel. Or if there's a panel that you wish were here, then you can go up to the window menu and you can go and find that panel name, make sure it's checked, and then that'll get it to show up. You can also create your own custom workspaces if you want. And so really you can just have a good old OCD time with workspaces and panels in Premiere Pro. And if you are like a really picky person like I am, then welcome home. You're gonna like it here. Premiere's got your back because you can customize just about anything in this program. Okay, so now we're gonna go up to the top left here to this panel that's called Project, and it's got the name of our project afterwards. This is our project panel, and it's like the refrigerator in our little Premiere Pro kitchen. So it's where we're gonna store all of the raw ingredients that we're gonna make our video with, so all the raw assets. But you can see right now, our project panel is empty, and she's really sad about that. So we need to get some media in her. So to import, we're gonna right click and select Import. We could also go up to File and go to Import, or we could go to our computer and just open up a Finder window and then go to that project folder that we made earlier. And by the way, you'll notice that Premiere has created some of its own folders in our project folder, and it's also created a Premiere Pro project inside there. And then to import these assets, we could just select the folders that we want and drag and drop them right into Premiere. And if you've got some big old files, then it might take a minute. Just give Premiere a moment, but then you'll see them come into Premiere. All right, so we've got our folders here, but now that they are in Premiere land, They're actually not called folders, they are called bins. And that's because back in the day, film used to be stored in actual physical bins. And if you need a new bin to organize something in your project, you can right-click in your project panel and select New Bin. You can also go down to this little New Bin icon here, or you can go to File, New, and New Bin, and you get yourself a new bin that way. Now I want you to repeat after me. Bins are my friends.
Bins are my friends.
And I want you to use bins to keep the assets in your project organized. So a lot of times I'll create a bin for each type of asset in my project. And so here I've got animations, captions, footage, graphics, music, and so on. And then I'll often organize my footage by the type of footage. And so here I've got A-roll, which is the footage of somebody talking, or if you're interviewing somebody, B-roll, which is the visuals that goes with what they're talking about. And then I've got C-roll, which is something I made up for the stuff that I source off of the computer or the internet, like GIFs of Betty White dabbing. The other way I'll organize my footage is by scene. And so here's footage from a wedding we shot, and we've got bins for different events that happen throughout the day chronologically. So I've got location shots, getting ready, first look, ceremony, cocktails, and so on. You can use bins to organize your assets and your footage however you want, do you boo, but just make sure that you keep things in order. Now let's talk about the view in this here project panel. So if your project panel looks like this and you've got these big old preview icons of these bins, then I don't think this is very helpful. I like to go down here to the bottom left, and you'll notice that we've got these view options. And I would go to the far left and I would select list view. I like this list view the best because, you know, a lot of times I have a lot of bins going on in my projects, and this lets me see as many of them at once as possible. And so I got a nice directory of all my assets, and then I can click whatever this little thing is called and expand bins, and then just have open only the bin that I need when I need it. Now, if I want to, I can also rename assets here in the project panel. So I could go here, I could click on this video clip, and I can see from the preview up here, it has something to do with the sky. And so I could press enter to rename it, and I could name this sky shot. And that's not gonna rename the file on your computer, it's just renaming it here in Premiere to make things easy for you. However, I try to avoid renaming anything in Premiere just in case things ever become unlinked. I know it's a worst case scenario, but then I wanna make sure that I've got everything named exactly the same in Premiere as on my computer, and every file's got its own special little name. So I'm gonna undo that out of paranoia, and then I'm gonna stretch this out so you can see a little bit more about these columns here. So if I expand one of these bins so you can see the files that are in them, then you're gonna see that we get basically a spreadsheet within Premiere of the metadata about these files. And just like any other spreadsheet, we can click at the top of one of the columns and sort by a certain piece of metadata. We can take one of the columns and drag it over and rearrange the order of them, or we can right click at the top of one of the columns and select metadata display. And that's gonna bring up this little pop-up window where we can customize exactly what metadata is shown in the spreadsheet. So what columns show up there, and y'all, look at how many options there are. I mean, there are so many, I can't even with this. All right, now I want you to notice this little search bar at the top of our project panel. This little search bar is gonna make you feel like a gangster because you can use it to find any file in your project like that. So I could search for a file by name. So I have a song in here called Honey. I type in Honey and boom, there it is. I could also search by file type. So I could type in MP3 and it's gonna show me all of the MP3 files. Or I could search for any other piece of metadata that I wanted. So let's say I wanted to show only the video file shot in 1080p. I'll type in 1080, and then you'll see that it's pulled up the video file shot in that resolution. Okay, enough nerding out about the metadata. It is time to create art, people. And so we wanna look at our video footage. And so I want you to go to your videos bin and double click that baby, and you'll notice that it has opened up in another panel in this tab on top of our project panel. And I don't want you covering that up, and so I'm gonna drag it over here so it's got its nice own little area. Then I'm gonna go over here to this tab and make sure that we've still got our directory of all of our assets over here on the left side. Now, when I look at my footage over here in this panel, you'll notice that it is in list view, and that's not very helpful for videos. And so I'm gonna go down to this bottom left where I've got my view options, and I'm gonna click icon view, and so much better. And now I've also got this slider here that I can adjust the size of the icons. And then I've got sort options here where I can tell Premiere what order I want these clips in. And so we could sort it by all sorts of ways, including name. We'd also sort it by user order, which is really cool because you can drag clips in any order you want and it's gonna remember this. You could also sort it by list view sort. So it's gonna sort it however you got it sorted in the list view. And this is an awesome one to use if you're filming an event with different cameras and you need your footage sorted in chronological order. If this is you, I didn't know about this for a long time, this is going to change your life. You are welcome in advance. So you wanna make sure first that you've got list view sort selected, and then you wanna go over to your view options and select list view. And then we're gonna go up here and you're gonna right click at the top of one of these columns and you're gonna select metadata display because we wanna add a column here. And so then you're gonna type in the search bar creation date. Now, you're gonna make sure that's checked, and what this is gonna do is gonna tell you the date and time that any asset in your project was originally created.
Created, do you mean when the video was originally recorded?
Yes, that's right. So creation date is gonna tell you the date and time that video footage was originally recorded by your camera. Okay, so we're gonna click okay. And now we're gonna scroll all the way to the right because that's where new columns get added. We're gonna click up here to sort by creation date. So to sort from beginning to end, then we're gonna go back to icon view. And now no matter what camera our footage came from, it's gonna be ordered from beginning to end, which is so beautiful. It's such a time saver. The trick to doing this though is to make sure that you set the date and time on your cameras. Otherwise, it's not gonna work.
T minus 10, 9, 8, ignition, liftoff.
Okay, how's your project looking? Because if it ain't looking like this, then now is the time to fix that. So whether you're working with our picnic files or you're already working on your own cinematic sequence, before you move on to the next lesson, your assignment is the following. First, set up your project folder and make sure you give each of your files a unique file name. Then go ahead and create your project in Premiere Pro. Next, import and organize your assets into your project and go ahead and create some bins however you want to. And lastly, I want you to open up a bin of your video footage in icon view and sort that footage however you'd like. And once you have that done, go ahead and move on and I will see you in the next lesson so that we can create your rough cut. All right, bye y'all.
Bins are my friends.
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 Okay.